My name is Akanksha Vachare, editor for A Subject Magazine, and I welcome you all to the online interaction on construction project safety and practices. The construction industry in India has been booming. Government programs and popular demand have fueled construction in various sectors, including commercial, industrial, and residential buildings, where building regulations and construction safety have not always been remarkably consistent in India. The tide is changing. Sensor-based technology is expected to bring a new generation of ways to increase construction safety management. Thanks to recent breakthroughs in identifying and processing the information. Keeping this plan in mind, ACE Update is conducting an online interaction on construction project safety and practices. The distinguished speakers for today's interaction on construction project safety and practices are Mr. C.R. Rajeshekar from Engineers India Limited, Mr. Anand Shinde from Sukhakarta Electromech Engineering Private Limited, and Ms. Neha Gurzar from CEM Engineers. So my first question to Mr. Rajeshekar. Rajeshekar, what are some of the most common safety violations on construction sites and how can they be prevented?
For example, I'm giving all the PPEs to the labor, right? From the helmet and then shoes, gloves, goggles, and safety belt. I'm allowing the worker to work at some 40 meter height. He is climbing there in the stage in scaffolding and he is working there. After reaching that 40 meter, he is supposed to do the hook up. In safety belt, we are having two hooks. That two hooks should be get hooked in the lifeline somewhere. What happened for small second, for a minute of second, they are not hooking. And they're just climbing to the some other level. And what is happening? That before not because of not hooking at proper time, some incident is happening. They are falling from the 40 meter height to directly to the ground. So direct fatal accident is happening. Even though we are giving all PPEs, all proper staging, and we are training them, but because of their unsafe fact, that because of their own behavioral act, they are losing their life. That means the supervisor should be always have to be in watch and ward condition, that until unless that labor getting hooked themselves, we should not allow them to start the work. That is the main concern. That is behavioral training we have to give. We have to teach them daily how to teach. We should have a toolbox meeting. At that, before starting off any work at a site, we should teach them, we should educate them, we should get knowledge them. That what is the value of a human life? And we have to tell them you are the only breadwinner of your family. Once you your life is got, you got death means what will happen to your family? What is will happen to your child? What will happen to your father and mother? So we have to teach them. We have to show their own importance to them. Once they got themselves having an importance, they will follow all the safety. That means education, daily education and routine education. To the safety is very important. And how to prevent it? Prevent means there are many ways. Administrative ways is there and engineering control is there. These two systems should act properly at your site. That means from the right, from the leader to the supervisor should have a work in a proper line and they should control everything as far as the workers' well-being is concerned. These construction workers, they are the driving force of the infrastructure. If you are not having a proper carpenter or barpenter, we can't be able to get this infrastructure right now which we are having. We won't get this proper roads, flyovers, this malls. Everything has been constructed by labor only. So we have to take care of the well-beings. Well-being by means of their proper HSC procedure to be followed. And they have to realize that we are working in a proper condition. And they have to work themselves that we should work in a proper safety atmosphere. That is the way.
Thank you, Mr. Rajeshekar, for enlightening us with such preventive measures. Moving on to Mr. Anand. Mr. Anand, how can electrical safety be integrated into the overall safety plan for construction sites? And what are some best practices for promoting a culture of safety awareness?
First thing is that they conduct the risk assessment. Second, they determine the weather, where electrical hazard. Third is the use testing equipment. Ensure the employee have proper training in electrical plus equipment, use voltage regulator and circuit breakers, use cord protectors, never work wet conditions in construction site, always wear personal protective equipment. these are the some key point of the implemented of the construction zone.
Thank you, Mr. Anand, for answering that. Moving on to Ms. Sneha. Sneha, how can the regulatory framework for construction safety be improved in India? And what role can the government, industry, associations, and other stakeholders play in this process?
For improving the regulatory framework, I believe, like very recently, we've had an emphasis from the government side on improving the health, safety, and environmental regulations, which we can see in the various standards which are being set out by departments like CPWD and going into IS codes and NBC. So you see that the regulatory framework is now building up to take it to the depth of the industry. We now need to ensure that it gets implemented at the smaller level projects, because we've seen, as far as working on government projects is concerned, these safety standards are adhered to. But I'm sure when we walk around our homes and we see construction going on, which is smaller in scale, we see it that it's not implemented. So regulating it at that scale through the government channels, like we regulate our designs. And so our designs are very well regulated now. That same level of regulation needs to happen as far as execution is concerned. And the policy framework for that needs to be in place now, which I think slowly and steadily has started to happen.
Thank you, Sneha, for sharing such deep insight. Moving on to Mr. Rajashekar, what role do safety protocols and procedures play in preventing accidents and injuries on construction sites?
The video I shown to you, that is a touching video. That when you just go through that, what is the root cause of that particular accident? No, proper procedure is not followed. Some rotary equipment, some shutdown work is going on, and labor is doing some work, kind of work, and he is trying to doing some repair. Then another operator, without knowing the person is working there, the operator started the machinery. That it resulted that accident. That means for this particular issue, proper electrical safety has not followed. For this particular incident, LOTO should be followed. Logout and tagout, that should be followed. Before taking a shutdown job, that they have to go for a proper permission. And this panel, from where this electricity is passing to that particular machine, that will be get locked by physical lock. And that lock, not only a single lock, it will be locked by three persons. The person who is giving the permission, the person who is going to work on that particular panel, and the third person who is going to work that labor. That means three lock will be there. All the three lock will be get locked simultaneously, and shutdown job will take place. Once the work is get completed, all the three person will come to the panel and they will release that lock so that everything will be intact. No person will get injured and no any kind of incidents will be get avoided. That means procedure is there. That procedure has not followed. That means procedure have to get followed. That knowledge should get to the labor also, to the supervisor also, and to the management also. That means the procedure already is there. That implementation of procedure should be get effectively done. That is the main.
Thank you, Mr. Rajashekar, for answering that. Moving on to Mr. Anand. Mr. Anand, what are the challenges in implementing construction safety guidelines and regulations in India? And how can these challenges be overcome?
Challenges to overcome implementing of the safety measurement at the construction site. First is to provide the training before full use and heavy equipment operation. Second, the access is site to identify and minimize the danger. Third is to require heavy worker to wear the protective equipment. Implement practice for safe site visit. Investigate how to reduce the fatigue. Six is install signs to remind people to risk and requirement. Establish process for repeating faulty equipment. Invest the construction wherever to improve the safety. And remain mindful to weather related to hazard. In implemented safety measures, to wear the PPE kit whenever your workers are doing work, to use the PPE kit. Otherwise, will be hazardous to harmful. Before, give the training to the non-skilled labor. Non-skilled labor doing the work and safety regulations not followed. Because of it is avoid the safety regulations. He doesn't know the how to use the safety PPE kit. To before, to giving the training proper, and after that, to follow up the one supervising, to he using the PPE kit or not. This is the guideline and the implementing safety measures at construction site.
Thank you, Mr. Anand, for letting us know the challenges and the ways to overcome these challenges. Ms. Neha, moving on to you. How can construction companies and contractors be held accountable for ensuring compliance with safety regulations? And what are some best practices for enforcing these regulations effectively?
So firstly, we have now a system of certification within the industry. As designers, we also get certified. As contractors also, we work with certified contractors. That ensures that they adhere to certain minimum baseline standards which they need to follow as a process. And not just for a particular project, but they do this across the board for the projects that they work on. That ensures that that kind of safety policy is ingrained in the workforce that they have. That just gives us more assurance that our sites will be safe. So yes, working with certified contractors is one thing. Now, the second thing is implementation of on-site programs. So these on-site programs need to be ensured by the contractor, the project management consultant, and the client. So not just in implementation, in execution, you also ensure a three-step process in implementation. That just reinforces the entire execution, because then it becomes top-down, and that really ensures safety at sites. And the third is recognition. So when a project is a success, any small fatality tarnishes a project. So recognition of zero accidents, recognition for the team, that's very, very important, because that incentivizes them to keep going a step ahead. So I think that's the process to follow.
Thank you, Sneha, for sharing your views on such safety measures. We have a few questions in the Q&A box. And we have a question from Pratha Bhattacharya. What are the top 5 hazards in scaffolding erection and dismantling? I would like Mr. Rajeshekar to answer this question.
Before going for a scaffolding erection, we should know for what purpose we are going to do the scaffolding. Whether we are going for a slab, or whether we are going for a staging, or whether that scaffolding is going to only for a column or a beam. That we have to say. That load calculation is very, very much important. Then what are the materials which we are going to use? That dia is very important, whether 40 mm dia is going to use or 45 mm dia is going to use. That dia material is very important. Third is the clamping, which clamp we should use, whether the clamp will take that particular load or not. The clamp and the pipe, that chemistry should get worked out. And fourth is that labor, whether the skilled labor we are engaging or unskilled labor we are engaging. These are three things. These are four things which we have to take care while doing the scaffolding. And when we are going for a de-scaffolding, no, that collapsing of scaffolding will take place. That means once we started to de-staging the scaffolding, no, the proper way should be get implemented. From when we are arranging, no, we are arranging from the ground to up. When we are de-scaffolding, no, we are de-scaffolding from the top to the down. That means stability. The stability will keep on reducing when we are de-scaffolding. That point we have to take care. This thing we have to take care while de-staging that scaffolding.
Thank you so much, Mr. Rajeshekar. I hope Pratha is happy with your answer. Moving on to Ms. Sanjana Kelkar, and she has a question for Sneha. And the question is, what are the current policies that are applicable for implementation of construction safety practices in India? And what change it has brought to the construction industry?
The current policies which are applicable vary from project to project. But in general, as far as construction is concerned, it is essentially client-centric as to what kind of policies they want to adhere to. There are times when they adhere to OSHA standards. There are times when they adhere to Indian standards or ISO standards. It totally depends on what kind of project and what kind of client you're working with. Having said that, the final outcome, all of these standards is to ensure safety and safe practices at site. So That's what we work with. And like we discussed, what change has it brought about? Now we see it going down to grassroots, like I've said before, that there is more emphasis because in the last decade or so, we have seen a whole lot of construction activity taking off in India, and it has necessitated this kind of action from the government.
Thank you, Sneha. Also, there's another question from Bakul Arora. How safety measures can be ensured at small scale projects and sites in small towns and regional areas? Sneha?
As far as safety measures are concerned, it's simple things. When you're scaffolding, there are certain safety precautions that need to be taken. Your staff at site, your labor at site needs to have the basic minimum protective gear. Now you have to ensure that how the material is stacked, the way your excavation happens. These are very small little things that can be ensured in small scale projects easily. The other thing which is very fatal is, yes, electrical works at site, on smaller sites as well, because it doesn't matter the scale of site. This part of the job is applicable to all kinds of projects. So safety measures when performing electrical work are standardized through the industry, and there is no escaping such standards.
Thank you, Sneha. Mr. Anand, we have another question, and I hope you will answer it. Are contractors paid enough to take care of safety of their workers?
Are contractors paid enough to take care of safety of their workers? It is a yes. Contractors paid enough when ESIC is the one policy to workers. So any incident in given incident on site, the ESIC our Indian government to protect your first can arrange the safety from the workers. As like that medical policy, all these policies are in ESIC in government.
Thank you so much, Mr. Anand, to answer that. Mr. Rajeshekar, what are the differences between fall protection and fall restraint system?
More or less the same only. There is no major difference. It is the same only.
All right, sir. With this, we have come to an end of the panel discussion. And we had very engaging and interesting submissions today. Now I request Archil to proceed with the closing of today's session.
Thank you, panelists, for exchanging your valuable thoughts on today's topic, construction project safety and practices. We hope you have enjoyed it. Before wrapping up today's session, we would like to thank our distinguished panelists, Mr. C.R. Rajeshekar, Mr. Anant Shinde, and Ms. Sneha Gurjar. For viewers who have joined us today, we would like to have your feedback and encourage you to stay connected with us via our social media handles. ACE Update is available on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can also download our app from Google Play and App Store. We would also request our viewers to stay tuned for future interactions. With that, today's interaction has now come to a close. Thank you and goodbye.